This Google recommendation makes no sense to me. It drives me up a wall. But I'll get to that in a moment. If you haven't heard, Google and Yahoo are rolling out new security and authentication requirements for email senders. You send any amount of email using a custom domain, something other than gmail.com, outlook.com, or yahoo.com, there's a chance that your email won't be delivered if you don't pay close attention here. So let me see if I can give you a quick summary of what's happening. Starting in February 2024, both Google and Yahoo are requiring email senders to authenticate their email domains, which I've talked about before, make one-click unsubscribe links, which I think is awesome, and then limit the rate at which people click the "this is spam" button when they get an email from you. Ultimately, the purpose of all of this is to minimize the threats we face with our email inbox, not just the flood of spam, but also the phishing emails that are pretending to be a company or a person that they're not. We need to be able to trust that when an email comes from mybank.com, that it's most certainly coming from my bank. It's possible to set up this authentication manually, which I've done before, but there is a reason that I use something like EasyDMARC to help with the process, which again, I'll explain in a moment. For now, you just need to understand that one glaring problem rising from all of this hoopla Google and Yahoo have created. Imagine that there's a rise in crime rates in your neighborhood. So the police visit your house to do a friendly security check. When they get to your front door, they realize that there is no actual door lock installed. As crazy as it sounds, anybody could walk into your house without a key. Now, obviously, the police are going to come back with a requirement for you to install a lock on your front door. I'd say that's a pretty good recommendation. But what if it came with a note that says, "Don't worry, you don't have to actually lock your door. We know that's inconvenient. Just make sure a lock is installed." That, my friends, is what we call pointless. And unfortunately, that's part of what I'm seeing happening with how email service providers are translating these new email security requirements. Authenticate your email with SPF, DKIM, and DMARC, they all say. But when it comes to enforcement, don't worry. You can set your DMARC policy to P equals none. Now, for those who don't understand what that means, SPF and DKIM records help to authenticate that an email comes from the real owner of that domain. So an email sent from allthingssecured.com should come only from me and not from anybody else who might want to pretend to be me in order to scam you, my audience. SPF and DKIM prove that I own the domain allthingssecured.com. DMARC, on the other hand, is just a simple rule that provides instructions on what to do if an email fails to pass this authentication test. So if a DMARC policy is set to none and somebody tries to send an email pretending to be me, that's the same as installing a lock on a door and keeping it unlocked so that anybody can still enter without a key. What's the point? Why in the world would Google and Yahoo or any of the email service providers think that this is a good thing? And yet this is exactly what Google says in their email guidelines. Now, I think I know what they're doing here. It's all about baby steps. If you've ever tried to set up legitimately secure DMARC policy on your own, you know how confusing and overwhelming it can be. If done incorrectly, you could find that all of your emails get blocked. And if you've ever received a raw DMARC report, you probably know what it felt like when researchers first discovered the Rosetta Stone. It is crazy confusing. If Google made full DMARC implementation a requirement, there would probably be a revolt. So instead, they're just asking people to install a lock on the door, and perhaps later down the line, they'll hope that you'll take your own initiative to lock that door since it's already been installed. But here's my question to you. Why wait? If you did a check on allthingssecured.com emails, and I'll leave a link to this checker in the description if you want to test your own domain, you'd see that I have my DMARC policy set to reject, which is the strongest DMARC policy you can have. I don't have a full-time email specialist on All Things Secure payroll. The only reason I feel confident doing this is, well, two reasons. One, I slowly tested my way up to a strong email authentication policy. And two, I continue to monitor my DMARC reports. And this is where a partner like EasyDMARC comes in. When I first decided to secure my email sending domain, I used EasyDMARC to confirm that I'd set up my SPF and DKIM records correctly. I've already done a full walkthrough of this if you want to check out that video next. Then I set my DMARC policy to none so that email delivery would in no way be interrupted, and I gave EasyDMARC the reins to my DMARC reports. These reports went from this to this. One is complete nonsense, at least to me, and the other is a visual representation of my email domain security and deliverability. I spent a month watching this report, and I'm glad I did because these reports helped me pinpoint every place where I was sending emails that I didn't even realize at the time. For example, my website host was sending contact form emails, and if I didn't set up SPF and DKIM authentication, those would have been blocked by a DMARC reject policy. Once all of this had been ironed out and I felt comfortable with how I'd secured my email domain, I then set my DMARC policy to P equals reject. At the end of the day, this is the standard you're aiming for if you own your own email domain. P equals reject. It's not enough to just install the lock on your door. You need to learn to engage the lock because that's the only way you'll actually be secure when using your own domain for email. If you've got a team that knows how to set up all this email authentication and has the expertise to handle the daily DMARC reports, good for you. But for everybody else, including myself, using a trusted partner like EasyDMARC makes all this possible without having that expertise. And guess what? Since implementing these settings last year, long before Google and Yahoo decided to make it a requirement, my reject policy has saved me multiple times from having a bad actor try to use my email domain for phishing attempts. I don't know who they are, I don't know what they were trying to do, but I can see in my EasyDMARC dashboard that they failed my authentication and were not delivered. I'm not a big fish, yet there are attempts to hijack my domain. Yours could most certainly be next. I told you last year the story about my friend Justin Moore from Creator Wizard, who started getting complaints from his audience about all the scam email he was sending, except he wasn't actually sending it. And you know the one thing that would have stopped this problem? A strong DMARC policy. Thankfully, he was able to get that set up and prevent these imposters from using his email domain again. Listen, I've been using EasyDMARC for over a year now to lock down and monitor my email domain authentication, which has provided me such peace of mind. And on top of that service, I've even started using their EasySender service to verify my email list and make sure that I'm only sending to legitimate emails. I recently connected it to my Google Postmaster account to monitor spam rates, delivery errors, and other data that comes directly from Google. This is what I use, and I'm proud that they've sponsored this video. And when it comes down to it, no matter how many emails you send or what basic requirements that Google and Yahoo set, there is no good reason why any domain owner shouldn't take advantage of full DMARC protection. Whether you set it up yourself, use EasyDMARC, or even some other vendor, just get it set up. It doesn't take very long, and once you've done it, you don't have to do much except check in on the reports every once in a while. Google and Yahoo have mandated that you install a lock on your door. My advice is that you simply lock it.